Welcome back to another video, everybody. So in this one, we're going to be talking a little bit about the big, bad hedge funds that aren't really necessarily all that big and bad anymore. They've been taking some very, very significant losses recently. So if you do enjoy seeing things like that, make sure you guys hit that like button down below, drop a comment, hit that subscribe button. And we're also going to be going over sort of where we see this going in the future and some tools that you guys can use every single day to make sure that you are able to kind of rub it in these institutions' face and beat them quarter over quarter, year over year, and really just kind of show that retail investors really aren't as dumb as everybody thinks they are. So again, guys, hit that like button, engage with the video, but let's get right into it here. We kind of have to go back a little bit and just kind of go over fund performance so far this year. So hedge funds are headed for one of their worst years of performance on record, leaving investors frustrated with how many managers have failed to offset sharp falls in equity in bond markets. In other words, do their job. Funds were down 5.6% on average in the first 6 months of 2022, according to HFR, while a narrower HFR daily index of performance shows them clawing back around 0.5% last month, so June and July. The industry is nevertheless on track for its second worst year of returns since 1990, when the data providers' records begin, only beaten by steep losses during the 2008 global financial crisis. So in general, this year, 2022, these funds have been taking very, very significant losses. Now, if you've been kind of reading the macroeconomic environment, we knew around last November that the Fed was going to start liftoff and the balance sheet runoff, and we were going to see some of this economic tightening come in. Now, these people are supposed to be the smartest individuals in the room, and they weren't able to adequately or appropriately position their portfolios. And we saw what happened with the overall market here, where if we look all the way back to the beginning of January here, we saw the peak of the market at around 480, and we're now chilling right around 399 at the time that I'm recording this video, with some very, very steep drops to those new lows at around 361. Now, again, when we take a look at this fund over here, hedge fund Pelham Capital pairs record losses, still down 33%. Their assets are now at $2 billion, down from $5 billion in 2020. So this fund has lost 60%, or $3 billion, since 2020. Now, if you think about a money manager and somebody who's managing outside money, you have to have some sort of risk control, a stop loss, something that is going to prevent you from losing 60% of your assets under management. Now, again, we all like to talk about and rag on Melvin Capital a little bit here, but the US SEC is investigating hedge fund Melvin Capital over what? Oh, risk management. So again, these funds in general have proven time and time again that they are completely unable to essentially gauge the macroeconomic environment and position themselves accordingly. Now, it's not just them that they're going to be affecting and their investors. These funds with all this money, they do affect you as an everyday retail investor, because if you start to see them fall below those maintenance margin requirements on any given stock or a stock in their portfolio that they're going to have to get liquidated on and add more money in. And if they can't, well, forced liquidations then happen, and then they have to sell, and it pushes prices down, and then your investment goes down. But there's been something going on recently with retail investors and our community that we have built that I think a lot of you guys would find very interesting. So we know that a lot of these funds are collapsing, but we also know, we've seen the CNBC stats, that like 80% of the US stock market is controlled by algorithms right now. There's a lot less human execution going on, which is a good and a bad thing. On the good side, you can have and take the emotional aspect out of trading. On the bad side, you could let these algorithms run rampant, and you can see very, very weird pricing. It limits price discovery sometimes. The algorithms are battling back and forth with each other. But at the end of the day, for retail traders fighting against not only the market, but also their emotional selves, algorithms are a very, very powerful tool. And I would like to showcase one of those with you guys today. So this right here, this screenshot that we have, is a screenshot from the first algorithm that we have released, called Trader Joe. Now, as you can see by this screenshot here, he was up today about 2.33%. And at the current time, the value of his portfolio is $12,253. But what did he start at? 10,000. So Trader Joe is up about 22.5% since inception, in essentially the end of April, while all of these other funds were taking these very, very significant losses. So essentially what this algorithm is doing, every retail trader has access to this. Again, if you guys do want more information on this, make sure you guys check out that link down below. This is Trader Joe. He is trading the tried and true basic 1348 rules, the 200 EMA, the crosses. He's got some other special sauce built into him as well. But again, every single trade that Trader Joe is taking, you guys have access to every single day. Pythagoras is a predictive algorithm, but these algorithms are super, super powerful. You can see that once they start to kind of get a hold of the trend, there are some very significant gains that are to be had with these algorithms. Now, when we come over here, this is kind of what it looks like here. So you can see he's profit taking over here. He's alerting every single person who is a part of our group of these trades that he is taking based on a lot of these crosses here. So at the end of the day, what you guys need to be able to do is, whether or not it is going to be with 1348, Trader Joe, and all of these other tools that we provide, you need to find a way to, one, take advantage of all the other opportunity that's in the market right now. These algorithms, again, they are incredibly powerful. They are the best tools that retail investor has access to right now. But at the end of the day, you're going to need to find the strategy that works for you. If this is something that you're interested in, make sure you check out that link down below. But again, when we're thinking about the market now and kind of how retail investors are labeled in general, retail investors are always labeled as dumb money when they don't really need to be. There are a lot of very, very intelligent retail investors out there that are changing the way that basically retail investors are actually viewing the market and enabling other retail investors to come in and really, really take control of their own portfolios and not be subject to basically what somebody else has to say or some weird theory out there that something could happen with this and this and this. But again, at the end of the day, you can control what you can control, and the market is going to be there for you guys to take advantage of all the time. So that is going to kind of wrap it up for this video, guys. If you did enjoy the information and analysis that I provided for you guys in this video, make sure you go down and hit that like button. It costs you nothing to do it, but it really helps us out a whole lot in getting this information out to as many people who do want to learn. If you guys do want to see more videos like this and do want more insight into these algorithms here, make sure you click that subscribe button and turn on that notification bell so you're notified every time I post a new video. So that's going to wrap it up for this one, guys. Other than that, hopefully you're having a great evening. Peace.